though you untie the winds and let them fight against the churches, through the yeasty waves confound and swallow navigation up, through bladed corn be lodged and trees blown down, though. What is this that rises like the issue of a king and wears upon his baby brow the round and top of sovereignty? Who can impress the forest? Bid the tree unfix his earthbound root. Sweet bottom is good, rebellious dead. Rise never till the wood of Burnham rise, and our high-placed Macbeth shall live the lease of nature. Pay his breath to time and mortal custom, yet my heart throbs to know one thing. Thou art too like the spirits of Banquo. Down, thy crown doth sear mine eyeballs, and thy hair, thou other gold-browed brow, is like the first, the third is like the former. A fourth. Start eyes, what will the line stretch out the crack of doom? Another yet? A seventh? I'll see no more. And yet the eighth appears to bear a glass, which shows me many more. And some I see that twofold balls and treble scepters carry. Horrible sight now I see, 'tis true, for the blood-blotted Banquo smiles upon me and points at them for his.
But why stands Macbeth thus amazedly? Come, sisters, cheer we up his spirits, and show the best of our delights. I'll charm the air to give a sound, while you perform your antic round, that this great king may kindly say, our duties did his welcome pay.
Time thou anticipates my dread exploits. The flighty purpose never is overtook, unless the deed go with it. From this moment the very firstlings in my heart shall be, the firstlings in my hand, and even now, to crown my thoughts with acts, be it thought and done, the castle of Macduff I will surprise.
Fire burn and cauldron bubble.
Bubble, double,
toil and trouble.